my way to see the merlion. I'm such a fan of this community. Like, as soon as I left my hotel or left the plane, there's just this like wave of community just hits you. Living in Vancouver, the air is really cool. You get like a lot of breeze from the ocean, and it's kind of like Arctic climate. I know a lot of people living in Asia kind of hate the humidity and really like it in like Canada. Although, personally, like I actually really love this climate. Even though I'm like sweating, as soon as I leave any building, still makes it feel like summer. I think why I like these travel vlogs so much is because it reminds me of a piece of my life that was missing before. As I skipped a vacation in the past. I love this breeze.
好吧，就让它吹了，吹到海中吹了。
Oh, my new day. So, like, if you stand around here.
Okay.
Get a lot of mist. I'll just get soaked for a bit. Palm tree is back again. One sec, I have to throw it to pose. Alright, so I know everyone knows that I'm a huge baller on Facebook because of my crazy pictures. Although that palm tree pic. I'm going to be rolling. I'm pretty much going to have girls on me all day and anytime. Why does everyone call this place the Shops and Marina Bay Sands? It is the Shopheads and Marina Bay Sands, alright? Same as Grande at Starbucks. It's Grande, alright? Am I like crazy? Like, is there something wrong with me or something? Like, feeling so hungover from Zouk last night. Gotta check it out. Zouk, 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 Zouk. Oh man, like, Singapore, honestly, amazing street food. Like, they have food centers, like, every, like, other street. It's, like, freaking crazy. It's, like, probably... Let me get some. Singapore is known for its laksa. So good if you're drunk and have laksa. It's like the best food I've ever had. Like even beats like McDonald's when you're drunk. It's crazy. Like Big Mac and Mac sauce. No, the laksa is actually better. It's like so good. Oh man, it's so cheap over here as well. $5 for like stuffed rice. Like if these few cents were around the place, I'll be here all the time. Can I get the roasted duck? Can I get the roasted duck rice?
Duck rice, can you hear?
No thanks.
In here,
yeah.
In
here? Duck rice!
$5. Yeah,
you want an egg to go with it?
Okay, cool, thanks. Okay, cool, yeah, sure. Okay. That's fine.
No.
Wait.
You want an egg, right?
Yeah, sure.
Extra
$180. $180, oh, okay.
Yes?
Sure. Thank you. Whoa, like, what the heck? Well, like, does anyone know what this bird is called? With a yellow beak? I've never seen that in my life. They're everywhere as well. Oh yeah, authentic Singapore breakfast. For $5, $6.80 with the egg. Crazy cheap. Like, I don't even think you can get a fast food burger in Vancouver for this much. And like, you get like a hearty, like actually healthy meal in Singapore. That's like really, really delicious. Oh. And they have this like every corner as well. It's like this kind of like gathering of people. So it's pretty chill just to go to these like they call them hawker centers. I thought the hawker center was like this like food court, like actually named the hawker center. No, it was like the actually like famous food court, but turned out like all of these food courts are just called hawker centers.
Okay.
so yeah, like I was just like googling like where's the hockey center, and there's like so many like hockey centers come up. Alright, let me try out this duck rice. It's pretty good. It's got some texture. Got some sauce. Pretty juicy. It's not the best duck rice I've had in my life. I'll look for something cheaper than like any breakfast meal you can get in Vancouver. It's pretty amazing. For Canadians, it's pretty easy to know the value of what you're paying for, because one Singaporean dollar is like almost exactly the same as one Canadian dollar. But everything in Singapore is just cheaper. Just like way, it's like just cheaper. So I guess Canadian dollar goes further in Singapore. Although for some reason the admission for clubs is like kind of awkwardly expensive. It's like $50. When in Vancouver it's like $20. And then like drinks are like awkwardly expensive as well. It's like $20 a drink. Maybe even like 20, 23, 24. So it's kind of strange when you're eating like delicious food like this for like $3, and then you go to a club and it's like everything's crazy expensive. Just to show you what I mean. The court we just ate at was right over there, right in the corner. And like literally, the next block is like another huge, huge freaking food court. Whoa, okay. Oreo coconut fresh milk. Crazy. I'll probably try that actually, that looks pretty interesting. If I was a local in the city though, I'd probably just buy a bike, like a 21 gear bike, and go pedal it like everywhere. It's so cool having scooters as well. In Vancouver, you have freaking no scooters. Like, baffles me. Like none at all. I think I saw one time at UBC. Some Asian chick was driving it around to go to her classes. But that's it. Like, it's just like a cheap alternative. Like, because you don't pay that much for gas for those scooters. So I don't even know if they're legal actually in Vancouver. It's like straight up, like the police will like pull you over if you're biking on the pedestrian walkway. You're supposed to be biking on the streets supposedly. Oh man, I'm just walking past all these stores, and this is like almost like most of the stores, vast majority, are all food stores. They're like really, really good and pretty cheap restaurants. Singapore is basically a foodie paradise. Like, some people live for food. Like, Like they wake up, they have a plan of which restaurants they want to visit, like with like 5-year reservation events. They have like everything all known, like the back of their hand. Although for me, I don't base my trips around food. Although I will definitely eat some delicious food. Walking through the Singaporean Mall, just found a key museum. Alright, so turns out they don't allow any photography in the cookie museum. I'm not sure exactly why. I didn't know that cookies could be so classified. Although I sampled out their lychee champagne flavor. Looked at all the samples, had a taster, and pretty good. It was definitely a premium cookie. So I just found this Starbucks. One of the craziest Starbucks I've ever been on. Okay, first off, it's got a freaking bar right there. You can like get wasted on caffeine, which is probably not the best idea, although still, it's pretty chill. And then it has second floor. If the bar wasn't enough, we have this entire floor. It's packed. It's like some serious studying. And then you have a boardroom. You can have like presentations about cappuccinos and lattes. Because yeah, like sometimes you just like, to the untrained person or to the non, sometimes to the non-coffee aficionados, you don't know what's the difference between a frappe and a latte. Like what's a latte? What is why is a latte? When did you want lattes? And I'll tell you, you wanted a latte as soon as you finish your typical lunch, and you wanted something a little bit tasty that can keep you going throughout the day. Alright, checking out the heart of Singapore, Orchard Road. Thank you. Really cool thing about Singapore, I found, is that they leave their malls open 24/7. Like, because usually there's like a store in there that's like open 24/7 or something. Even if there's not, they just leave it open. So it's pretty awesome to not close like all these public places past like in Vancouver it's like 8 p.m. Onsen bath in there. Let's take a dip.
Yeah.
Luckily, they have a crosswalk to the other side street, although there's absolutely no crosswalk on these two streets. So it took me a while to get to this corner. I always check out McDonald's every country I go to. And like this McDonald's, I tried to order the Coke, although they have a Coke Zero Sugar, and then they have a Coke less sugar, but they don't have a Coke full sugar. And then I bought the Coke, and then I didn't get a straw. And then I asked the lady, "Hey, can you get a straw?" And she looked at me so weird. And I was like, and then I didn't see that there's actually a lid. Pop open and drink it like coffee. Amazing. On my way. Universal Studios Singapore!
Thank you.
basically I have no idea where I'm going, although I see the cable cars, so I will go over there. just take the cable car there. Well, finally at the cable car to Sentosa Island. Somebody popping on it, saying, "Doodaloo! See ya, Sentosa Island!" Jump on off this commando style.
We are now arriving at Sentosa Station. If you are disembarking here, please exit through the gift shop and remember to take all your belongings with you. Enjoy your stay on this city.
Studios Singapore! It's been a while. Gotta throw some poses. So it's pretty easy to get lost in these gardens by the bay. It's just so massive. Although if you look up and see the pillars, then you can get a general idea of where you are.
foreigners.
Venture to Pandora. Don't eat me. One with the forest. We are together in this forest. We are all forest creatures. But I'm just saying, I could probably beat up that tiger, so...
Okay.
Like, if I was in Pandora, I would go crazy with the bow. Like, be like... crazy bow marksman. Oh, it's Mysteri. Yeah, I'll have to check on Mysteri. I wonder what they'll do for Pandora 3, for Avatar 3. Since the humans made Pandora all the time, like, what if... Pandora invaded the humans, right? Like a what if all these guys came over to Earth? That will change it up for sure.
And that's a way to say that my mother has a dad.
It's aerodactyl. Let me try to jump on it real fast. I'm ready to pop on ice. Okay, I'm just joking. Please don't kick me out of having a party experience. Honestly though, I don't expect Avatar 3 in a few years. So Avatar 1 is the largest movie out there, right? At the time. And then Avatar 2, for some reason, was only in theaters for like a month and didn't have that much advertisement. Although, some people are telling me that like the reason why Avatar 2 took so long is because it took like 3 years to render. So I don't know how long it's gonna render for Avatar 3. Hopefully like nobody like turns off the computers partway through the rendering.
Thank you. Thank you.